Today we're talking about the most effective time to take melatonin and the most effective time to get light exposure. This is based on the phase response curve. Before we jump in, I'd like to invite you to get my free melatonin brand guide for physicians. It's your guide to high-quality, third-party tested melatonin supplements, including many of the products that I use in my practice. You can get the free guide at intrabalance.com/melatonin. A quick disclaimer, the information I'm presenting today is information only and is not medical advice. Okay, so let's talk about the most effective times to take melatonin and to get bright light. If you ever work with patients who say, I tried melatonin and it didn't work for me, this could be one of the reasons why. Because when it comes to melatonin and light exposure, timing makes a big difference. So understanding the PRC will help you guide your patients with regard to timing. This is the phase response curve, or the PRC. Let's look at it in a little bit more detail. On the x-axis here, you have time. On the y-axis, this tells you whether or not melatonin given at a certain time is going to cause a phase delay or make someone fall asleep and wake up later, or if it's going to cause a phase advance, which is to fall asleep and wake up earlier. You can determine what time to administer melatonin based on this, and also what time to administer light. The red line here represents melatonin. The blue line represents light. Anything above this black line is going to pull sleep earlier or advance the circadian phase. Anything given below this line is going to push sleep later or delay the circadian phase. The larger the amplitude of the wave, the more of an impact that intervention is going to have. Looking at this red line here, you can see the wave is at a peak here with the melatonin right about here. So we'll explain what that means in a minute. And then look at these big waves here. That represents the size of the effect of light exposure at those times. Okay, so here's what this all means. Oftentimes people will take melatonin about an hour or two before bedtime. So let's look at what that actually does. Taking melatonin about an hour or two before bedtime has a little bit of an effect, but not that much of an effect if you want to advance the bedtime or shift sleep onset earlier. If someone's taking melatonin for its sedative effects, then they might be fine taking it around an hour or two before bedtime. But if they're taking melatonin with the purpose of trying to advance or pull their sleep onset earlier, then the maximal effect is actually going to be here, which is about 4 to 6 hours before sleep onset. So around dinner time, it's going to have a maximal effect. Taking it too early is going to have less of an effect. On the flip side, taking it in the morning is going to push sleep later or delay the circadian phase. The same principle applies to light. Let's look at this blue line here. Getting light after the minimum core body temperature, which is typically about 2 to 3 hours before a person's usual wake time. Light exposure after that minimum core body temperature is going to have a maximal effect on advancing the sleep phase or pulling sleep earlier. Getting light exposure during the sleep zone shortly before that minimum core body temperature is actually going to push sleep later. It's going to delay sleep onset. I like to use this graphic with my patients to explain to them how the timing of melatonin and the timing of light therapy has an impact on their body clock. If you found this video helpful, go ahead and click the like button, and then check out my video on prescribing bright light therapy to learn more about how to use light therapy for sleep and mood disorders.